guys, and welcome back to another video. So today is not a career vlog. Today is actually the very first vlog from my time since coming back home to England. So I am now going to be posting both my vlogs from Korea and my present day vlogs from England at the same time, just because I don't want to fall behind on all of my vlogs from anything that I do now that I'm back here in the UK. So this is the first thing that I vlogged when I came back to the UK, and it is another concert vlog because apparently I didn't do enough concerts while I was in Korea. So I went to 3 more after coming back to England. But this is a super exciting vlog because I went to London to see Take That in concert, which is so exciting because I've never seen Take That before. I absolutely love Take That. I was obsessed with them when I was a kid. They were one of my favorite artists growing up, and I even had a Take That phase while I was living in Korea. I have no idea how it happened, but at some point when I was in Korea, I got back into Take That and had a solid few weeks where I listened to nothing but Take That. And then after that phase, they announced this tour, and I was like, oh my god, I can actually go to one of their concerts. And I got the ticket while I was in Korea. And it's also exciting because the support act is Olly Murs, who I also loved as a kid growing up. So I get to see two artists who I've never seen before, who I absolutely love, in one go. It was absolutely perfect. And this is the vlog of that experience. I hope you guys enjoy. I'm wearing TXT merch because I see Olly Murs today. And Olly Murs wrote TXT's song Magic. And I saw TXT perform Magic like 6 times during my time living in Korea. And I really like it. It's a really good song. So props to Olly Murs for writing that one. So I'm wearing my TXT merch because Olly helped write one of their songs, and I don't own any specific Olly or Take That merch. So TXT merch it is today. I'm at the O2. I've done entire laps inside and outside, and I cannot find the Take That merch store. I swear it's a thing. Is it not open anymore? I swear it. I can't find it, you guys. I'm going insane. But it's good to be back at the O2. A lot of it's changed. There's not a Build-A-Bear here anymore. I definitely just walked past it. I don't know how I didn't clock this. Up. It's like gone 3 o'clock. I'm heading to my hotel, or like trying to find my hotel. It's one stop on the subway and then like a 15 minute walk. Oh, I found it. I got my merch, and then I went to Five Guys and got takeout, which I'm bringing back to the hotel to eat.
I'm on the same floor that I lived in when I was in Korea, 13th floor. How cute. kind of creepy.
This is the concert look. The program has these 3D glasses in, and there were some 3D pages in the program. But from one tweet that I've seen, it looks like you might be able to use these during the concert for Greatest Days and This Life. I don't know if that's just for the looks aesthetic. Maybe they're gonna have some cool effect on stage. I don't know, but I'm gonna take these back to the venue with me when I go for the concert, just in case I actually need them for something. Which, if they incorporate 3D into the concert, that's gonna be so cool.
New fit for the concert. I figured I might as well put on the merch for the concert.
It's nearly 6 o'clock. I came to the hotel. I had a little nap just because I didn't know what else to do. And then I ate my Five Guys, and now I've just gotten ready and I'm gonna head straight there, I think. I was just thinking, I don't know what to expect right now because I haven't gone to a concert in England in over 2 years. The last concert I went to in England was at the O2 Arena. It was to see JLS. And that was December 2021. And it's now May 2024. It's been a while, but I went to like nearly 50 concerts in the space of 2 years while I was in Korea. But concert culture is so different in Korea. And the whole time I was in Korea, I was always saying that I don't like concert culture in Korea and I prefer it in England. But now that I'm in England about to go to a concert, I'm like, did I really mean that? We're about to find out. I can't remember how different it is. Like, can it really be that different going to a concert in England compared to Korea? I think it could be. This one probably not as different because people are gonna be sat down for most of the concert. From what I've heard, the audience don't typically stand up. I'm hoping my section might stand up, but in England you typically stand up more. Can I even think of all the differences? Firstly, bag checks. They don't do bag checks in Korea, which is still crazy to me. You could take your own drinks and food in. Like, I don't think there are staff shouting at you before the concert. I could not stand that in Korea. They would have staff walking around inside the arena, like when you were sat down in your seat. The staff would be walking around for like the hour before the concert started, shouting out instructions and rules and stuff. And it used to stress me out so much. Concerts are already overwhelming and overstimulating enough. I do not need the staff shouting out the same thing over and over again for an hour when I'm trying to relax and get ready for the concert. I don't think they do that here, which will be nice. You're allowed to film here. Love that for us. It's easier to leave the concert during the concert to like go to the bathroom or go get more drinks. In Korea, they're super strict with leaving the venue. It feels like it shouldn't be that different, but I feel like I'm gonna get there and I'm gonna have like major reverse culture shock. Let's go see Take That and Ollie Murs. I am so excited. I think it's really sinking in. Let's go. Let's go.
And if at any point you feel the sudden urge to shake your body and throw your arms in the air uncontrollably, then please feel free to express yourself any way you want, in a safe and responsible manner, of course. Welcome to This Life, because this life is yours.
Please welcome on stage, in association with This Life Entertainment, Ollie Murs.
Thank you. love the way that you move, and I see all of you now controlling me. It's the kind of like it when you bring me to my knees. Come on, you got my passion around your fingers. I do anything for your love now, baby. When you touch it, the feeling lingers. Takes me up so high. Since I'm intelligent, yeah. You wanna be a man, spoon for the hell of it. I'll be the student, you be the teacher. Mr. Physical, it's your pleasure to be a child. You don't know love till it tears up your heart and cuts it, leaves you with scars. Lost, love and say, you don't know love, you don't know. Show and I'm feeling super excited, super pumped. Listen, welcome to the Take That Tour 2024! Ladies and gentlemen, you have got me for the next 45 minutes. But listen, honestly, it's a true honor to be in the Take That Tour. It's a real honor to be on this stage. And honestly, it's gonna be, you're gonna have a great time tonight. Trying to cover it up, cause the jazz dance moves it. Cause normally I try to run, and I might even wanna hide, cause I never knew what I wanted till I looked into your eyes. So am I in this alone? What I'm looking for is a sign. Is that you feel how I feel for you, honey? So baby, please don't let me go. Baby, please don't let me go. Dear darling, please excuse my. Have you enjoyed it? And no, I've got one more question to ask you all. Where's all my troublemakers at? Yeah, keep coming back again. Oh, troublemaker, that's your little name. I know you're no good, but you're we
Just another night, feeling lost. The God just lying underneath the stars.
Oh, it sounds like we've got a nice lively audience in the O2 tonight. Well, this is my idea of a very nice day out. This is. Anyway, welcome to the show, everybody. We hope you all have a wonderful night. It's our last night in London. We are going to have the best night ever with you tonight.
Hey girl, I know situations change. One of you, and welcome to This Life TV. And all that's left really for me to say at this point is, well, let's get on with the music.
That's Gary Barlow, that is. From Take That. Yeah. We're going to take you on a bit of a Take That journey, London. Are you up for that?
Was going to be an all singing, all dancing extravaganza. So me, Mark, Howard, Robbie and Jason, we packed our leather jackets and microphones and we set off to conquer the world.
Hey, we want the wings of love.
is to go our separate ways.
Please welcome Gary Barlow.
Love, it has so many beautiful faces.
Mark Owen.
Somebody help Clementine.
Idea. Should we get the band back together?
Could be the greatest day of our lives.
part, but we're not finished just yet, so stay in your seats.
Absolutely right, Gazza.
Thank you all so much for being here. That's enough. We'll see you soon.
Greetings, I'm walking home. It has gone 11, it is quite late. I think the concert finished around about 10:30-ish. The concert was really good. My seat was good as well. I was third row of the fourth floor. I don't know how I managed to get third row when I did the ticket sale in Korea, and I missed the initial release time. But hey, it was a really good seat. People did stand up for some songs every now and again. When they did a really upbeat song, people would stand up. So I was able to stand up at some of the songs that I wanted to like dance for, which was really good. And the glasses, they did the 3D thing. It was so cool. It was, the screens had like the 3D effect on them. And I think the lighting and even their costumes kind of looked cool. So I don't know if they did something with those as well. But like if you wore the glasses, it looked so cool. I was the only one in my section wearing the glasses. And I think some people were laughing at me because they did look kind of daft. But it was worth it because it was so cool. I've never seen anyone do that at a concert before. It was really cool. I really liked it. Honestly, I wish they did it for more than just two songs. I think it would have been better received if everyone had access to the glasses, if they like gave them out to people going in or something, rather than you having to buy the program, because it meant when they played the VCR for it, like no one knew really what they were talking about unless you have the program. I don't think I would have known about it unless I'd seen someone mention on Twitter that you could wear the glasses during the concert. I would have bought the program anyway, but I don't think it was clear from the program that you needed the glasses during the concert. I would have left them in the hotel instead of taking them to the venue, and then I wouldn't have been able to do it. So I feel like they needed to make that more of a thing.
It is 4 a.m. and I'm sat on the desk watching outside because there's a thunderstorm right now. Rain woke me up. Ooh. The rain woke me up, and then I could see like behind my closed eyelids a flash of lightning even with my eyes closed and the curtains drawn. So I was like, I need to see this. I love thunderstorms. There was a massive lightning streak right down in front of me, and I literally stopped filming like 1 second before it. It's so cool though. I have such a good view. There's still lightning going on. Oh.
Hello, it is hot. Wow, my voice is kind of off. I sang too much last night, but it is currently 10:30 and I am about to leave my hotel. I did eventually get to sleep last night because there was a thunderstorm at like 3-4, and then I tried to go back to bed, and then we had another thunderstorm at like 5-6 a.m. which I also got up to watch, and I saw some good lightning during that one. So I spent most of last night lightning watching. I love lightning. Now I'm heading to King's Cross Station to meet with a friend who I haven't seen in ages, because I think the last time I saw them was Comic-Con, I want to say. They're one of my cosplay friends, who I met through a group that I cosplayed with. And I think the last time I saw them was MCM Comic-Con, October 2021. That's the last time I saw them. They've actually come down to London today specifically to see me, which is really lovely. It'll be a super chill day. Chilling in London with my friend, and then I'll head home later today. Okay, that is the end of this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. It was so much fun getting to see Ollie Murs and Take That. It was so much fun. I had such a good time. So that's been this vlog. My next UK vlogs include more concerts, because a few weeks later, I went back to the O2 to see Girls Aloud, which was even more of a bigger deal than seeing Take That was. Look forward to that vlog, and I'll see you all in my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.